Hello everybody, this is Kevin, and since I'm going to be moving, my systems are packed up for the most part, and I can't record anything on those, I decided that I was going to start my next Let's Play a little bit early. It's actually fairly quick to record, so let me ask you viewers, do you like an RPG where you need to grind endlessly until eventually you reach a cap on your level? Do you like an RPG where the battle system is based off of cards on whether how strong you attack or your defense is? Tell me, viewers, do you like Dragon Ball Z? If so, get ready for my next Let's Play. Let's play Dragon Ball Z Legend of the Super Saiyan. Now, I am doing this with live commentary, viewers. And yes, I know I ripped off that intro from H.C. Bailey's Dragon Warrior, but I only thought it appropriate because, you know what, if I need to explain that to you, I don't think you'll get it, even if I try. So, this is a Super Nintendo game. As you can see, it was released in 1992 for the Super Famicom in Japan only, viewers. Please, I'm going to ask right now, please, Do not ask me how to get this ROM. Alright? This is played on an emulator. A Super Nintendo emulator. Alright? I've patched it with a patch that I also found. It's pretty accurate. It's very nice and clean. So that's why I decided to use it. And, basically, the only thing I have to say is that, I'm going to be playing through this game the way I want to. I don't know if I'm going to be able to show every single little thing, because I've actually done test runs of this game before. I've actually LP'd it in the past, but I took it off this channel, and that's one big long thing. But it doesn't matter, viewers. The point is that I'm Let's Playing it again. And I don't want this title to repeat. Alright, so I'm going to start a new game, obviously. And just like the series, we get Raditz here. He's all like, "The Saiyan Raditz suddenly arrived on Earth. Aha! Kakarot, my scouter has found you." Yeah, I don't think he actually sounds like that, but that sounds more like Vegeta or something. "Hello, little brother. I see you have not yet completed your mission. No matter. I'm taking your son. If you want to see him again, you will kill 100 humans by tomorrow." "Can Goku save his son? Earth's strongest fighters challenge the villainous Saiyan." Yeah, I don't use myself. Anyway, so, this is the game. Now, before I even do anything, I need to go over a few things with you guys. You have controls up, down, left, right. You have A, which opens up your menu. B, which cancels out any option you do choose. But that doesn't matter. Well, actually, it does, but for right now, it doesn't matter. Now, A, it opens up your menu. You have talk, look, fly, item, and menu. The first three are pretty much self-explanatory. You talk to people, you look at things, investigate. If you ever played Earthbound, yeah. Fly, I don't think I need to explain what that's all about. If you've ever seen Dragon Ball Z or know, like, any inkling of it. As for item, you get items throughout the game, which you can use here. You have a limited amount of inventory space, so make sure you use good use of it. Anyway, menu. Now, this is different. Cards, we're going to ignore that. Status. This will take you to see your characters and their stats, their moves that they can use, how much ki it costs. Ki is basically MP in this game for you Final Fantasy fanatics, and how much experience they need to gain to the next level. As you can see, Goku starts with Ki Blast, just a basic blast using his Ki. Energy Wave, a little stronger version, costs double the Ki, but does double the damage, obviously. Solar Flare. Now, Solar Flare is kind of a hit or miss in battle. Basically, what it does is it's used to stun enemies, so you can then attack them physically. It is completely and almost utterly useless. I don't know if I'll ever use it. And then the almighty Kamehameha, if I need to explain that to you and what it is, I think you should just go watch Dragon Ball Z, viewers. It's Goku's signature move, and that's all I'm going to say. As for Piccolo, he has a light grenade, which is, in Japanese translation, Makoho, But they've English, they've translated it to the English name, which is Light Grenade. I personally didn't mind it being called Makoho. He says it whenever he uses it in this game, even in the translation. But it doesn't matter. And he has his Demon Wave, which is called, like, the Super Beam Cannon, if I'm not mistaken, in the English anime. Order, just the order that you want to put characters in, they show up, it's not too big a deal. Later I'll be reordering stuff text. How fast you want it to go, faster or slower. I'm going to have it on 3, it's actually a good speed to have it at. It annoys me because it exits out whenever I choose it. And save, save, save. So, that's pretty much it for the menu based on the overworld map. For now, there's a little house here, so let's go inside and see what's going on. Oh, look! It's our favorite, Z-Fighters. Well, technically, we adventured with most of them. One of them's our master. Basically, if you've never seen the series, this is Bulma. She says, Gohan's hat had a Dragon Ball in it! You can use the Dragon Radar to find him! And just like in the cartoon, she gives you the Dragon Radar. I'm going to go over that item right now, because it's actually pretty important. Dragon Radar, just how you think it sounds and does, detects Dragon Balls. You use it from the item menu, has an incessant beeping annoying sound, and you press A multiple times, and it will basically be like a radar-type system, where it'll give you a blinking dot, which tells you where the Dragon Ball is. That's how you're supposed to know how to find Gohan in the first, part of the game, as of right now. Let's talk to this guy. This is Krillin. He grew up with Goku and trained with him under that bearded guy over there whose name is Master Roshi. He says, I'd offer to help, but I'm not strong enough. Don't die, Goku! And Piccolo's just like, Piccolo, yeah. He's like, you too, Piccolo. Anyway, he gives us a turtle card. Well, they're called items, but they're basically kind of like cards. 6 points. As you can see, it says 6 points there. That's how much Zenny is worth. That's the currency in this game. In the Japanese version, I believe it was just gold, but in American translation, anything that's gold in Japan is Zenny in America, like we all know. So it's Zenny. What the turtle card does, it evens out the card's offense and defense between all your cards. So let me go and actually explain the cards now. These are the basic default cards you'll always begin the game with. Each one has a different symbol. Each symbol does different things. As you can see there, the one I'm going to explain right now is the one in the middle that looks like a cross. That is a key card. Alright? Whenever you use that in a battle, you'll cast a key attack, unless you don't have enough key to cast an attack, in which case you'll just do a normal physical attack. I'll explain more about cards once I actually get into a battle. But for right now, that's basically what I wanted to show you. Turtle cards aren't super handy, but you can use them for whenever you get really crappy cards, and you just can't do anything. Anyway, so let's start flying up towards where we saw that dot. It was kind of like northwest of Kami's Island. Kami? It's not Kami. Roshi. Oh, God, I've disgraced everyone who's ever watched Dragon Ball. Anyway, so this is a battle. Now, in a battle, you have four essential things that you can do. You can attack, use an item, run away, or go into your menu, look at your stats, change your order, change the text speed for whatever reason. Now, I'm going to safe state just to show you guys a few things. Normally, I don't like safe stating. I don't plan to do it super often. The only time I'm ever going to do it is when I want to demonstrate something or before a battle, if I keep messing up, and I'm going to edit out all the mess-ups of a battle. Especially during a certain battle where some body switching happens, viewers, if you know what I mean. Anyway, now, this is the reason I wanted to show you the safe state. Let's say you choose the run option, you were unable to escape. As you can see, all my cards just dropped a level in terms of offense and defense. I don't want that to happen! So, this is what I'm going to explain to you next. You have, when you go to attack, you have pick and auto. Auto chooses the first two cards for you pretty much automatically, as you'll see here. Piccolo attacks the Junior Saiyan Man. Well, it doesn't actually pick the first two cards. It picks the two strongest cards that you have with you. And I'll be honest with you, I don't want to do that either. Okay? That is bad. Auto, it's an option if you're just being lazy. Any game with auto battling, I never like using it. Now, I should actually explain. If you're using a control pad and you hit X, you can see how much HP is left on your enemy and their battle power. Battle power in this game is actually a little iffy. It's not really proper to say battle power is exactly how much stronger you are than your enemy or not, because it's still based on stats. Like, let's say you're at the cap level in this game. By the way, the cap level in this game for every character, except for a few, is 47. Alright, so after level 47, you no longer gain experience, or rather, you can no longer gain a level. You can still gain experience because, well, we'll get there later. Anyway, and your characters will have close to 1,000,000 battle power, and sometimes they can still gain damage from an enemy that, let's say, has like 1,000 battle power, and that just doesn't seem possible at all. But if you actually do get strong enough early on in the game, which you can start grinding as soon as you get to a certain point in the game to gain the max level. Then, and only then, viewers, will you gain the ability to not be able to be damaged by enemies. You'll see eventually, in an upcoming battle, what I mean. It won't be us that won't be getting damaged, it'll be something else, but don't worry. Anyway, for now, I just want to take care of the Saiyan Man. He's a Saiyan Man Jr. I'm going to explain another thing right here. See, as you can see on the top, there's a Z here. That is the attack power. And then the bottom, there's a snail. That's the defense power. Now, I'm not sure about the defense, but as for attack, it's pretty simple. You get 1 through Z. Z being the strongest, 1 being the weakest. Anything in between, that's about average. Your opponent also picks a card, and they basically match up against yours, and whoever has a stronger one goes first, and etc., etc. So, yeah. Now, if I'm not mistaken, actually, I might be mistaken about that being defense. It might actually be speed. So if it is, then the snail is actually the slowest card. While I think, and the Z is actually the fastest, if I'm not mistaken. I think I might have read somewhere that it didn't represent defense, it represented speed. So I'm actually going to think it represents speed, and the snail being the slowest, the Z is fastest. Anyway, I'm getting tired of listening to this battle music, so I'm going to choose this card right here. Actually, I'm not, but I'm gonna choose to show you what it does. As you can see, it matches up with Goku's symbol. It's called a favorite card. Whenever you choose it, it attacks everyone on screen. In this case, I actually don't want to choose it since I only have one character that I'm fighting against, and I want to go for this card. It's relatively one of our weaker cards, yet it'll still get the job done. Now, whenever you choose one character to fight, you don't actually have to send both in. You can press the X button, and you can only send one character in if you want to, which is what I'm going to do at this point. So, let's deck this battle out. Yeah, oh, headbutt. Oh, dude, that actually looked like it hurt. And, yeah, basically, whoever has the faster speed goes first, and whoever has the stronger attack does more damage. Now, as you can see there, Cybermen got a cheap shot on us, so that wasn't super good. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to send Piccolo, since I just got a key card, to go and use his, not Demon Wave, I'm going to send him to use his Light Grenade, and I'm going to let Goku sit back, because Goku just got like a heavy hit. So, yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's pretty much, this game is pretty simple, guys. I mean, I can't explain it more than this. And if you think I need to, then tell me in the comments, and I might try to explain something more, but really, this is pretty much it. By the way, I guess there's something else I should mention here. Like I said, I am doing live commentary on this, so I can see. Oh. And I'm back. Anyway, so as I was saying before that random battle rudely interrupted me, I can see a timer on this, so what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be splitting this up into episodes of like 15 minutes or something. This one obviously is going to run over a little bit longer just because it's the first episode, but I think I'm actually going to end it off here and explain some other stuff next episode. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you next time. This is Kevin saying bye-bye.